Hey TechKnowSurge, in this video, we're gonna take a look at a Windows machine and see what Multicast memberships that it subscribes to because it has IPv6 running on its interface. I'm on my demo laptop right here, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn on Wireshark to monitor the Ethernet interface, and then I'm gonna plug it into the switch. And we are going to see what memberships then it becomes a part of, and what the information, those packets that are sent out, the frames that are sent out to become part of that membership. So here I have the Wireshark is up. I'm going to double click my Ethernet connection. Notice there's nothing coming across it right now because it's not plugged in. So I'm gonna plug this in and then we'll see what traffic comes across of it. Now that we've plugged in this device, I've stopped the capture of this. We've got a lot of data now of what traffic goes across this interface when you plug it in. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sort by protocol, and what I'm looking for are the ISCMP version 6 packets that are in here. And so I look at these and I see some multicast listener report message. So I look in here and we see the some specific, this is a colon 14. So this is the multicast address associated with the IP address that we assigned to this device, the static IP address. I click on this one, same thing we've got there. So we can see that it subscribes to some of these multicast addresses in here. And what I can do is I can pull up a command prompt and I can type in netsh interface IPv6 show joins. This is a command that we've used before to take a look at what multicast addresses it's joined to. So I can see here is the Ethernet interface. I'll move this down here towards the bottom so we can see some of the list. And as I scroll through these, we can see that, well, FF02:FB is on that list down there. And same thing with FF02:C. So it's subscribing to these different lists out there, these different memberships, multicast memberships. And so some of the ones that it subscribes to, we got this this FF02:1:FF00:14. That's the solicited node multicast group that's associated with the static IP address that we assigned to it. And then we also see this FF02:1:FFD7:34FA. That's associated with the link local address that we had on this. So that's the solicited node multicast address associated with the link local. And just to verify that ends in 34FA. I can type in here ipconfig and scroll to our Ethernet. And here's the link local, and it ends in 34FA. So yes, so we see that this is the link local address. It's created a solicited node multicast address, and then it's registered that solicited node multicast address so that it can receive messages that are destined for that multicast address. So there you have it. So there, that's part of the process of this. It creates that solicited node multicast address, and then it registers that to be part of that multicast membership. I hope these videos are really helping you out. If they are, I'd really appreciate you hitting that like button.